either you try to use Java, that class name, okay, or else you try to specify jar that file name or that class name, what happens is the class which is being specified at the command line while executing this particular program, okay, JVM expects a particular class should contain that published static void main method, right? Public static void main method. Okay, so what happens is that is the driver class which is going to, that is the driver code which is going to start with the JVM, the method of execution, and from that driver code only what is going to happen, either your mapper class or else your reducer class is going to be called. Okay, so that is the reason what we are doing is we are defining three classes. One is mapper class, second thing is reducer class, and third one is the driver code. That is the driver code which is going to do the main logic, and through this particular main logic only this mapper and reducer are supposed to be executed. Okay, so we started with the mapper class, word mapper. Okay, within that word mapper what we did is I told you a class is a normal class, but if you want to have that class to be, if you want to have that class to be acting as a mapper class, that class should do two things. What are the two things here? One is you should extend the parent class, which is nothing but your map reducer reduce base, as well as you should implement a particular interface. That interface is called as the mapper interface here. Okay, so whenever you are implementing any interface, what should happen is that whatever the methods that are defined in that map interface has to be overridden. Okay, that is what is called as a runtime polymorphism. So Shashank, I hope you are aware of this runtime polymorphism, right? Even in C# also as well.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay, so here what I'm doing is that one thing what I'm going to override is, I'm going to override this particular map method, which is an method of this mapper interface. Okay, so what we are expected to do, we are expected to pass key value pair to this mapper, as well as again key value pair as input, as well as key value pair as output to that mapper here. Okay, input to the mapper as well as output to the mapper, we need to pass this particular key value pairs. Okay, so in such a context, So in such a context, what we need to do here, we need to specify the key value pair. So initially, suppose if this is zero, and then if this is specified as higher, how are you? What is in here? Zero is going to be the byte offset, and then this is going to be the entire line. So this zero is going to be given as key, and then hi, how are you is going to be given as this particular text here. Okay, and whatever the output that you want to collect, that output is being collected with the help of a class. That output is being collected with the help of a class, which is going to have two parameters. One is nothing but the text, and second thing is the int writable. Okay, and we are defining this one as output here, and then this reporter is also being specified. I'll tell you the significance of this particular reporter at a later point of time, but for now, you please keep it as a mandate for every mapper or reducer, what we are writing, what you are defining, try to have this particular reporter to be defined as the fourth parameter over there. Okay, so Shashank, can you please define what is the purpose of this mapper? What should it do in this particular word count example?
So it should take in the key value input from the record reader and then convert it into a key value format.
It should convert into key value pairs. Okay, for the purpose of converting this one into the key value pairs, one thing what we need to do is that, as I have told you, this thing what you are seeing here, text is there, right? This text is nothing but a box data type, which is nothing but the Hadoop data type, right? So for the purpose of applying any type of string operations, what you are expected to do, you are expected to convert your box types into the primitive types. Okay, for the purpose of converting the box types into the primitive types, the first thing that you need to do is you need to use something called as value dot toString. This is the something that you need to use for the purpose of converting that into the string. If your box type is converted into the string, which is nothing but the primitive data type, then only you can have the option of applying those particular functions in that on that string object, right? On that string data type. Okay, so for the purpose of this one, see here, what is going to happen here? So within this particular string is what you're hanging here, you're hanging this high value, high how are you is existing. High how are you is existing. Okay, now what I need to do? I need to start splitting this line of text into multiple strings. Okay, and then pass on those particular strings as the key value pairs. Okay, so I hope everybody knows what is the purpose of this split function. Okay, in this split function, what we are doing is that this high is going to be broken. How is going to be broken, R is going to be broken, as well as U is going to be broken. So what is the differentiator for the purpose of splitting this high and how? Can you please tell me? Shashank?
Space.
It is nothing but the space. This is nothing but the space that we need to do, use. Hi, Sarudan, how are you? Long time.
No, only one session I missed. Sorry, I haven't got
okay.
No, I missed only Friday, actually. That's all.
Friday you missed. Okay. Yeah. Good, right? You're doing good?
Yes, I'm good.
Okay. So one thing is I have given each and every member the Hadoop VM access. Okay. So okay. I don't know whether you have got my email or not.
So that is the access to the machines, right, Ravi?
Access to the virtual machine.
Right. I saw that email. I'll after this class I'll log on.
One thing what I'm requesting is this week's sessions are going to be very much important, Sarvaran, because we are going to discuss in detail this MapReduce paradigm, as well as we are also going to discuss Hadoop one is based on this MapReduce paradigm. I hope you know that one. Okay.
But the moment
once we switch on to this Hadoop 2, you have this yet another resource negotiator that has come up, which is nothing but the YARN.
Okay.
I also would like to discuss in detail at a very greater depth and breadth the internals of your YARN architecture also as well before we start going into this ecosystem next week. Okay. So these sessions, Monday to Friday sessions, are very much important. Kindly make sure that if possible, you please don't miss those particular sessions, basically. Okay?
Sure, Ravi. I won't miss anything. Sure. No problem.
Thank you. Yeah, no problem. So here, what we are doing is that we want to split this one. With the help of this particular space here. Okay, so that's why wherever this particular split is coming, space is coming, I'm splitting these particular strings. Okay. Now the thing is, why I am checking this word dot length is greater than zero? Can anybody tell me why this word dot length is greater than zero here? Suppose if I specify hi, two spaces I am giving, three spaces I am giving, and I am specifying something like how are you? Okay, so it will try to split the first word at this particular space. So assume that this has splitted. Okay, the moment it has splitted, Okay, again at the next split also you are going to have the space. So that's why when this word is being splitted, you are going to have something called as space only, where length is not greater than zero at that particular point of time. So what happens is that since you have a fat finger, whenever you are trying to key in the text, there might be more than one space that is left between two consecutive words. That is the reason we are trying to count this word dot length is going to be greater than zero or not. So in case if it is going to be greater than zero, what we are doing is that we are going to use this output collector. We have this particular collect method, and through this one, what we are doing is that we are trying to give this one as a new text of word. Okay, why are you using Saravanan? And one more thing what we discussed is we discussed about the box types and the primitive types also as well. Okay, so string is a primitive type as well as text is a box type. Box type means these are the Hadoop data types what we are discussing. Okay, so since primitive data types cannot be directly used as a parameters using these MapReduce methods, what we need to do is that we need to convert it back to the text. That is the reason we are using this new text of word. Okay, and then what we are doing is that initially if you are trying to split this one, what is the first thing that you are going to have here? You are going to have something like one, right? So again, you are going to have something like another key value pair is how one, r one, as well as u one.
Yes.
R one as well as going to have something like u one like this. U one. Okay. So for these things, what I want to do is that for each and every key value key, it is going to be one only, right? So that is the reason what we are doing here. One is basically an integer, but integer cannot be used. That is the reason what I'm doing is I'm going to convert this one into the new iteratable, and then I'm closing this one. Okay, this is what is your mapper class. Okay, Divya, I have a question. If this is your input string, if this is going to be your input string, can you please tell me when this input string is being, when this input text is being iterated in the for loop, can you tell me when that is going to end, when that loop is going to end, and what condition is not getting satisfied if this loop is going to end? What condition is going to be satisfied if this loop is not going to end? Murali, question to you. Can you tell when are we going to end this loop?
Of a line character.
It's a new line character, right?
Yeah.
The moment once hi, how are you is completed, obviously what you are going to do is that you are going to get this new line character, backslash n. You are going to get this new line character. You are going to get this new line character. Sorry. So, since you really don't have any, I'm going to split only this particular thing, split off. But after you, since you don't see any space, since you're going to see this particular new line character, what it is going to do is that it is going to come out of this particular loop, and then it is going to end this mapper class. It is going to end this particular mapper class here in this case. Okay. Now, initially here zero is also the key, okay, and here one is the value. My question to you is that why one is being used as the iteratable and zero is being used as a long writable? Any idea why are we using zero as long writable and one as iteratable? Can anybody tell me what is the major difference between int and long, Shashank?
Because that is a byte offset, it can go beyond the integer max value.
Yeah, byte offset means suppose you are taking a file which is crossing 3 or 4 terabytes in size. Okay, and you know the integer will be having a maximum value, right? What is that maximum value? 32,767 something of that sort will be there. Okay, if it exceeds that value, that iteratable will not be in a position to hold that particular value. That is the reason what we are doing is that we are trying to convert that one into long writable. Thanks, Murali. But whenever we are trying to output this one as whenever we are trying to output this one as a output value, one is always an integer, right? So that's why there is no need for you to use that one as long writable. But since this one will suffice, what is that one that will suffice here? Interwritable will suffice. That's why we are specifying this interwritable in this particular case, right? This is how this is going to be executed. Now, how many times this mapper class is going to be executed, Murali or Shashank?
The number of lines it's broken into, that many times the mapper class is processed.
See, the number of lines multiplied by the number of input splits also as well, right? The number of lines by the number of input splits also as well. That many times this is going to be executed, and for each and every execution, it is going to emit this key value pairs. It is going to emit this key value pairs. Okay. Now the next question is, as soon as this key value pairs are emitted and once your mapper is done, what is something that is going to work out? What is one thing that is going to fire once again? So this is mapper. I hope everybody has understood. Now tell me what should we do as soon as your mapper is done? As soon as your mapper is completed, what is the next action that is going to be done?
You need to aggregate on the intermediate results.
Yeah, 1 minute. Suppose your file is of hi, how are you? Who is your family? Family, how is spring season going? How is the spring season going? This is the thing that you are having here. Okay, now I'm splitting this one into two lines. Okay, one is hi, how are you is one split. Hi, how are you is one split, and how is your family is another split. Okay, then you have one more thing that is existing, that is nothing but your how is spring season going. Okay, now here you need to have two value pairs, right? So what is the first value pair here? That is hi one, how one, and then u one. Okay, then again how one, right? How one is one. Your one, family one. Okay, like this it is. And here it is going to be O one is one, thing one, season one, going one. This is how this is printed. Now your mapper is done. Now tell me what will happen now. Shashank, Divya.
It will create an intermediary data set with all the key value pairs.
What is the process called?
Shuffle sort.
Yeah, the process is called as shuffle sort. Okay, so how is the process going to be called? So here I'm going to specify hi. Okay, it is going to give this one here. What is that one here? This is one, comma. Only one is there, right? Only one. I one. Then you're going to have how. How many times how has come? This is one, and this is one. Like that is going to come. Okay. And R is only one. R is only one. And then U is also only one. What are the things that are remaining here? Is.
Yeah.
For is, what I can do is that I can use this one as 1, 1. If you have known Java, what is this set called here? This is what is called as a collection, right? We call this one as a collection. Okay, for processing these collections, Java comes up with a new type of data structure, and the structure is called as the iterator. So that means that if I want to loop through a set of values, okay, for the purpose of performing any type of arithmetic operation, any arithmetic operations, here what I need to do is that I need to start using a type of collector interface, and that particular collector interface is called as iterator interface. Shashank, do you have any such type of structure in C#?
I think we have it, Ravi, but I'm not sure about
it. Okay, got you, no problem. So this is intermediate output, RSL, shuffle and sort. Let's save this one. Done. Now we're going to create a new class, and what we do is that we call this class as word reducer class. Reducer class. Okay, so example, what you're having here is I have a word reducer which is of how, comma, and I have this iterator which is saying 1, 1, 3, 4, 7, like that. I have this this many times. This is the output of your shuffle and sort, right? This is the output of your shuffle and sort. Okay, so a question before we go ahead and then start working on this reducer class, can anybody tell me when can we say a class is called as a mapper class? When can we say a class is a mapper class?
When it extends
MapReduce as well as when it implements
and map implements
MapReduce. When it extends MapReduce base, and then when it implements mapper class, then we call this one as a mapper class. Okay. 1 minute, I guess. Okay. So now what we'll be doing is that let us start writing this class here. And one thing, if you guys are thoroughly interested in writing this MapReduce programs, you'll be able to improve your logic. Okay, but one thing what you need to understand is that if you want to pursue some careers in Hadoop, okay, there is no need for you to be an expert in MapReduce. Okay, without being an expert in MapReduce also as well, you can excel your career path using Hadoop. Why? Because there are a lot number of ecosystem tools that has come into the market. Okay, those system tools are, you can use Pig, you can use Hive, you can use HBase, you can use Woozy, you can use Scoop, you can use Zookeeper, like that. So many types of tools are there. Okay, you can start using any of those particular tools in order to work as a, you can start working as a big data analyst, you can start working as a data scientist, you can start working as a Hadoop architect. Okay, you can start working as a Hadoop ETL specialist by learning Scala and Spark, as well as you can always go as an Hadoop admin, like the way Sarvaran would like to go also as well. These things are there. If you are a real core developer, you can also go as a Hadoop developer with the help of Yarn and MapReduce also as well. But one thing is that how many MapReduce applications you are having, how many ecosystems you are having, okay, but the ultimate base is going to be your MapReduce only. Ultimately, in whatever, no matter whatever code you are going to use, it has to be ultimately translated into MapReduce code only, okay? So here I'm using this one as public class. This is word reducer. Word reducer. What I want to do here, I want to extends. What is the name of the class, Shashank?
Map reduce base.
Map reduce base. Okay. As well as earlier it implemented mapper, but this time it wants to implement this reducer. It should implement this reducer. Okay. So within this reducer, what you are having here, we need to pass some input. What is this input here? This input is nothing but your how. Okay. What is the data type that I need to specify here? The data type that I need to specify is nothing but the text. Okay. Which is nothing but a key value pair. Please understand, everything is going to be key value pair only here. Text key. Okay. And then what is the next one you're having here? The next one is not one or zero. It is nothing but that collection. So what is that collection I'm calling here? That collection is called as an iterator. That collection is called as an iterator. And within that iterator, what we are going to do is I'm going to give some data types. What is the data type that I want to specify here? The data type is nothing but your iteratable. The data type is nothing but your iteratable. Okay. And is it a single value or else it is a set of values? They are nothing but the set of values that I want to specify here. These are nothing but the set of values. Then obviously you need to have this output collector also as well. Output collector. Okay. Then you need to have this particular text that I want to have along with iteratable. Iteratable. Close this one. Output collector of 1 minute. Iteratable. Okay, then you are also expected to have this report rar also as well. Report rar. Rar also as well, you need to write report rar. Okay, then it should throw output exception. The reason is that since you are passing these values to the writer, which is supposed to write to the file, okay, that is the reason what we do is that we try to throw this output expression. Please don't ask me why this is going to throw this IO exception. The reason is that this reducer interface, okay, is going to have these methods which is definitely throwing this particular exception for this particular methods. That is the reason what we are doing is that we are trying to throw this particular IO exception in this particular case. We're trying to throw this IO exception in this particular case here. Okay, so this is the reducer. Now, let me tell you one thing. Whenever you are implementing this signature, okay, this signature can be the part of your interface also as well, or else this signature can also be the part of your method that you are going to overwrite also as well. The signature can also be the part of the method that you are going to overwrite also as well. So there we have implemented that mapper, right? There we have implemented that mapper. Okay, here what we are going to do is that we are going to implement this particular reducer. So that's why public void reduce. Map we have implemented, this is what is the reduce that we want to implement. Okay, so here you can have the option of taking these values exactly as it is. How can we do
this? Are we in that signature output collector text comma interwritable? Is that like a argument function brace, or is it, or like what is it?
No, no, brace. This is the class constructor. This is the class constructor. For that one, we are going to pass these two parameters as the parameters over there, Murali. You're going to pass these two parameters as the variables over there. Okay.
So that less than symbol is, I mean, that's a normal brace, right?
Which one?
After output collector, right? After output collector. That function arguments is passed in less than greater than.
This construct arguments we need to define as an interface here. It should be defined as an interface here, basically. That's why we need to use this less than and greater than symbols over there. Sorry.
Oh, okay.
This should be used as less than and greater than symbols here. You have seen this mapper here?
In mapper.
Text are interoperable. What is one thing that you are asking? Can you please tell me?
I mean that angular brace. Here you have given like normal braces, right? To the output
yeah,
collector.
You were asking about the thing. So that is a typo bus.
Okay, okay. Yeah, I was like, I'm new to Java, so I'm just asking. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So angular brace is right, is it?
Yeah. Okay. So I want to use this reduce. For this reduce, what I want to do is that I can directly use this one here. Like, is there any cut function that exists in this case here?
Ravi, I have a question. Why you are not using the Eclipse to writing this program?
See, I'm just showing you in the Notepad or in the Paint how we are going to write this one. Okay, once this reducer class is completed, tomorrow we are going to write this one using Eclipse. Okay, I'll be showing you, okay, what are all the libraries that you need to import, as well as how you need to do the course correction for those particular Eclipse program. Okay, along with that one, within Eclipse only, we are going to write the driver class also as well. Come on. Okay.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm.
Ravi, I think you can just copy that and then paste it. Select it, copy that and paste it.
Anyway, let me do this one. I'm not good at this paint pass. And come on, one more thing. Every time there is no need for you to write these things using Eclipse also as well. Like Eclipse is a platform where you can have the option of writing these Java programs. Okay. If you are good at Linux, you can also have the option of writing these programs using what we can say. Using VI editor also you can do that one, you know. Values. And here for this method, you can specify this throw IO exception in this case. Exception. Okay. Now tell me, what should we do now here? What is the purpose of this reducer division? What is the purpose of this reducer? Why are we using this reducer here?
To find the final output and give the count of the word accurately from.
What is the final output? You are talking about the final output and to give the count, right? To give the count.
Yes.
So yeah. For the purpose of calculating the count, what we need to do is that I would like to initialize a variable, and this initialization is what is called as count is equal to zero. I'd like to initialize a variable which is nothing but your count is equal to zero. Okay. Now, what we want to do here? I want to loop through these particular values, right? I want to loop through all these particular values. Okay. For the purpose of looping these values, I can have the option of using the for loop as well as I can also have the option of using this while loop also as well. Okay. So what I do is that while values. So Murli and Kamran, what is that values? Where from I am referring these values?
This is your iterator.
This is your iterator, right? So this is your iterator. Yeah. So this iterator will have a function. Okay, that function is nothing but has next of.
Yeah, it will execute at the end of the thing.
Yeah, it
when
will be able to recursively iterate through those particular values. Okay, recursively iterate those particular values, and then it will be retrieving all those particular values basically. Okay, so this is a condition that I'm going to specify. Values has next of. Okay, then what is one thing that I want to do here? First thing what I want to do is that I would like to initialize this value, that is int writable I is equal to int writable I is equal to values dot next of values dot next of. Shashank, I have a question. Why I'm using this iterable here? Why I am declaring I as iterable?
Because it need to you need to typecast that value into iterable.
See one thing. This iterator values are nothing but the key value pairs that you are getting from this shuffle and sort method, right? That you're getting from the shuffle and sort method. Okay, in that shuffle and sort method is a MapReduce based data types. So that's why you will have only those iterable values only. You'll be having only those iterable values only. So whenever you are trying to retrieve those integers from the list of that iterator class, okay, using that next method, obviously what happens is that the return type is always going to be iterable only. It is not going to be int. You understood the difference, Shashank and Murli and Sarvan and Divya?
Could you repeat that, Ravi?
See, you are seeing here, right? How in this one, who is going to return these values? Shuffle and sort, right?
Yes.
Shuffle and sort. So when they're returning those values, what is the value? What is the data type of how? Is it a string or text?
It's text.
It is a text. Text is a box data type. Okay. Similarly, what are the data types of those 1, 1, 1, 1, 1? Is it int or iterable?
It's iterable.
Iterable, right? So whenever you are returning those values from that list, and then when you are assigning to a particular variable, that variable also should be of iterable type, right? That variable also should be of iterable, right? Divya, you are following?
Yes, Ravi, I'm able to get that.
here, in such a case, what is the value of I you are going to have here? The value of I, what you are going to have is nothing but I is equal to 1. Okay, now what should we do? I have renewed the first value. So, but I have initialized this count as 0, right? I have initialized this count as 0. So, is it not that this I has to be added to that count over there?
Yes, it has to be. Count
so
has to be.
Can you tell me what is the, how should I add that I to that count? Can I specify something like count is equal to count plus I?
Count writable.
Count plus, sir?
Count plus new int writable. How
Wait.
Can you?
Okay. Can I specify count is equal to count plus I?
No, you have to convert that to int.
So what is the method that we can use for the purpose of converting that int writable to int?
New int writable and
yes.
Pass that parameter.
Hey, for converting int to int writable?
Get method.
So I need to use that particular I dot get off. That's the point now. Need to use this count is equal to count dot get off in use. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sarvan, you are following. Why are we doing this one? Why are you using this particular get function? What is this next function? What is this has next? What are these things? You are able to follow, Sarvan?
Not really, Ravi. But what I'll do is I'll not interrupt the flow of this class. So
okay.
Once after this class, I'll go ahead and do my own research, and then I'll be able to follow. Don't worry. Please go ahead.
No. The reason why I'm saying here is. Where did I cover? You see, let me tell you a long story in a short way.
Sure.
In Java, you have two things. Java, core Java is there, as well as MapReduce based Java is there. Core Java
okay.
along with MapReduce based Java is there.
Okay.
So in core Java, I think I have mentioned these things, right? Okay. In here, you can see here. In core Java, you have these primitive types, int, float, double, long, string, character are there.
Okay.
And in Hadoop-based Java, what you're having here is you have these data types, int writable, float writable, double writable, long writable, and text.
Okay.
And whatever the mapper and reducer methods or the functions what you are writing, they will understand only these things only. They will understand only the box data types. They don't work with the primitive data types.
Okay.
So that's why in the signatures of all the methods, what you are specifying text, you are specifying int writable, you are specifying long writable, like that you are specifying over there.
Right.
Okay. But one thing what you need to understand is we are performing any types of arithmetic calculations. The arithmetic calculations might be plus, minus, while loop, for loop. Okay. All those particular things has to be performed only with respect to the primitive data types. What are those primitive data types? These are all the primitive data types what you are having here.
Okay.
These are all the primitive data types what you are having here. So if the box data types has to be participated within the calculations, obviously what we need to do is that we need to typecast. Okay. Typecasting means we need to convert the box data types into the primitive data types, especially when you want to have this particular box things to be performed in the arithmetic calculations.
Okay.
For doing that one, see here, for the purpose of converting these things to the primitive data types, what we do is that we use this particular get function for converting the box data types into the primitive data types, we'll use that one. Okay. And for converting your text to the string, what we do is that we use this particular two string of. This is the thing that we generally use here. Okay. Similarly, as I told you, right, the mapper method or the reducer method will accept only key value pairs, and key value pairs should always be only of this box data types only. Should be of only of the box data types. So that's why what we need to do is that when you pass, when you want to pass this integer, floating and all as the parameters to the box data types, what we do is that we use this one here. For converting this integer into the iteratable, we use this one as new iteratable of int. Similarly, new float writable of float, new double writable of double, new long writable of this one. And similarly, what we do is that we also specify something called as a new text of string. New okay. text of string. This is the conversions that should happen between the printed data types and the box data types server name. Okay.
Sure. Nice explanation. Good explanation.
Yeah. And another thing what you need to understand is that key value pairs should always be of the box data type only. Key value pairs should always be of the box data types only. But internally, when you're doing these calculations, that should be of the primitive data types. So we need to frame our mind in such a way that the wherever places, wherever it is required, we should have the option of converting them one-on-one basis. That is the way that we need to convert. Okay.
Okay, sure.
So where is this one? This is the thing that we're creating here. So count is equal to count dot I get of. Okay. Once we do this one, what is the next step that we need to do here? Count is equal to count dot I get of. So finally, the count is going to get some value called as how many things are there that is going to contain this particular value. Okay. Now what should we do here? We need to pass on these particular values. What are those values here? That value is nothing but the key. And what is the final value error hang here? The final value is there in count. But Divya, what is the data type of count here? What is the data type of count here?
If data type, int.
The data type of this one is integer, right? So here I can specify this one as output.correct of. I specify key as this. Key is always a text data type. But how can we convert this integer into iteratable?
New iteratable
of it, right?
Yes.
This is how I'm supposed to convert your map reducer. This is the way I'm supposed to create your reducer class.
Is it not count,
right?
Sorry, count. From counting. Yeah. This is what is your reducer class. Okay. Either in this reducer class or in the mapper class, are they self-sustaining or they are not self-sustaining? Are they self-sustaining or they are not self-sustaining? Divya. Self-sustaining means can I execute these classes as it is? This class are the
no,
class.
We can't.
We cannot execute we have because they doesn't have the main method, right?
Yeah.
As long as doesn't have the main method, we'll not be able to execute them independently. Okay. That is the reason we need to have a particular class or a particular Java program that will be able to marry this writer class as well as this, mapper class and this reducer class. And then it should also have this context of this, where should we write this particular files? Okay, mapper and reducer, as what I have told you, is only doing that particular logic. Okay, but for the purpose of executing this program, I have told you the flowchart, right? What is the flowchart? Whenever the client is submitting the program, he need to specify the name of the file. He also need to specify the output directory where the file has to be written. Okay, we also need to specify the type of the file. Okay, we also need to specify how exactly this record writer is going to exist, as well as how exactly this record writer is going to come into the picture. These are all the things that we need to define, right, divisions and Sarvanan.
Yes, Ravi.
These are all the things that we need to define. So that particular thing is expected to come in this driver class, and we will cover this particular driver code tomorrow. Okay, before going to the driver code class also, the first thing what I'm going to do is that, as suggested by Kamran, we'll take this particular Eclipse. Please mention, Murali, have you installed your this one?
Yeah, I did.
Is it working fine?
Yeah, it's working fine.
It has got all the things, right? So
yeah.
So please make sure that your Eclipse is there, okay? As well as please make sure that the terminal is also there. Please hold on, please, 1 minute. Let it come up. Okay, you need to start doing this tomorrow. As soon as you are done, and one more thing, Sarvanan, please ping your phone number also as well to me.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll add to that group over there.
Okay.
So you need to have Eclipse. You need to have the terminal. You need to produce, you need to complete this MapReduce local system commands, local file system commands in the form of Linux, as well as you need to complete your Hadoop HDFS commands also as well. These are all the things that you need to do, guys. I don't know what you're going to do. I'll be telling you those. I'll be sending you that material also as well by tomorrow, so that you need to start working on those things. Okay, see here, this is the Eclipse that you are expected to have. This is the Eclipse that you are expected to have here. To this project, and within this project I'll specify this Java project and click on this next, and specify this one as project as a word count project, and so it will be coming up with the src folder. Yes. When you start working on this one, it will be coming up with the SRC folder here. This is the SRC folder, and within this one, we are going to write all these particular classes. All these things we'll be seeing it tomorrow, Kamran. Okay. We'll be creating the mapper class. I'll be telling you the reducer class. I'll also be telling you how to work on this driver code also as well tomorrow itself. Making sure that we complete this entire exercise by tomorrow. Once we are done, okay, maybe day after tomorrow, you yourself will go ahead and then execute this particular program. I already have told you how to execute this particular program, but once again, I'll be telling you how should we execute this particular program. Once that is done, I think tomorrow is Tuesday, Wednesday. I think by Thursday afternoon, half of the session will be working on this map reducer. Once it is done, I'll be giving you a couple of examples that you need to really work it out. Okay. And then from Thursday afternoon, second session onwards, what I do is that I'll start working with Yarn. Okay. So Divya, are you getting clear how exactly this map reduce is working and how this is working with respect to your Hadoop architecture that we have discussed? Are these things clear to you?
Yes, Ravi.
Murli?
Yeah, it is clear.
Yeah. Kamran, I hope you missed a couple of sessions, but kindly get all those recorded sessions and then follow them also as well.
Yes. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I will be doing. Yes. I have a quick question, like in the installation is Oracle player and VM player both. Just hang on
you
a minute.
Use, I will both, but you start using either this Oracle VM box or else you can use this VM player at 12. Always the better.
Okay.
In case if you want
to. Okay. But I did like the Oracle because I don't have too much capacity. It's saying like the 20 GB minimum required. Yeah.
See, but you have seen this versions, okay. The version what you are using is Hadoop 2.2, but the latest one that you have got is Hadoop 2.6. Okay. If you really want to work on such a type of thing also as well, I have this option to you. If you want, I can also tell you the instructions for Cloudera. Yeah, okay. We also have this Cloudera also as well.
Okay, Cloudera is there remote user ID and password as anything, Cloudera?
No. Cloudera. That's it.
Okay.
I can download that the Cloudera virtual machine, and then also okay. I can start working on that one. Should not be a problem.
Okay.
So please make sure that you are having two or three distributions. One is CentOS. Okay, the other one is Hotter Networks. You can use. Okay, and the third option what you can have is you can have the option of using Cloudera. Mahout or Mapper you please don't use. Why? Because they don't go by the normal plain vanilla map reduce things, but they go on their customize the map reduce programs that they have built. So that's why don't go with that mapper, but try to confirm yourself to the Hotter Networks or to the Cloudera or to this CentOS virtual machines basically. These things.
Okay.
Any questions before we conclude today? Sarvan, you are feeling okay. I understand that something is itching you, but still.
Hello. Look like it's offline, I believe so.
Okay. So Ravi.
Okay. Yeah, tell me.
I just have one question, one quick question. So at the point of shuffle and sort, is that a internal process which is done, or is that code exposed
process.
To us?
It's an internal process. That won't be exposed outside. The record okay. reader and then the shuffle and sort is something which will not be exposed, Shashank.
So for any kind of efficiency, do we need to customize that shuffle and sort algorithm?
No, that is internal to this one.
Cool. Thank you.
Okay.
Yep.
The moment once we see this driver code class tomorrow, you'll be able to understand how exactly this is being done. Okay.
Sure.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. Have a good
night. Thank you. Have a good night.
Yeah, good night, Divya. Bye.
Bye.
Night, Ravi.
Night, Ravi.